Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to find out how to create an interactive software simulation in PowerPoint. Here's a preview of the software simulation. It basically just consists of screenshots of the software, with tooltips and hyperlinks to guide you through all the features of the program. Let's go through those steps one by one. I'll start here by showing you how to take a screenshot of a software window, in this case, the iSpring Converter Quick Start window. One handy tool you can use in Windows is the snipping tool. Just press the Start button on the keyboard and start typing snip, and there it is. Here in the new dropdown, select Window Snip and click on the window you want to snip. Right now it's in the clipboard so you can paste it in PowerPoint, but you can also create a catalog of snips by using the Save feature. But let's close out of here and check out a faster way. First, make sure your application window is selected, then just hold the Alt key on your keyboard and press Print Screen. That will take a screenshot of the currently selected window. On some laptops, you may also have to hold the Function key to access the Print Screen function. Now that it's in the clipboard, switch over to PowerPoint and paste it right on the slide with Control V. This way, you can switch back and forth from your software to PowerPoint and create a whole catalog of slides for whatever screens you want to show. You'll also want to resize the image to fit the slide as closely as possible, and then go to the Design tab. From here, select a custom slide size that fits your application window perfectly. Right now, I'm using a custom slide size that fits Kaspersky Antivirus, so I'll just proceed with that. Alright, so now we have a screenshot of Kaspersky, and we want to make it interactive. So we'll just go to the Insert tab and insert a square right over this button. Now up here in the Shape Styles, we'll pick Transparent. Finally, we'll right-click it and create a hyperlink that goes to the slide containing the Cloud Protection screenshot. Okay, now we want to indicate that this is the right button to push, so we're going to go back to Insert and add a little callout. Drag this little guy over here so it's pointing to the button. Then pick a theme that matches nicely with the software color scheme but still stands out. Now type in your instruction, and you can also add a fade animation to draw attention to it. You also might want to set a delay of about a second. Alright, now you can insert a text box that describes this screen, and choose a quick style that makes it stand out. Again, you can make it fade in to draw attention. Let's go over here to this completed slide. As you can see, the design is a little different, but you can see what I'm talking about. Now, over here on the Cloud Protection slide, we prompt them to go back to the main screen, and that actually takes them over to this different slide, which now has labels for all these buttons. This all works exactly the same way. Just keep adding transparent rectangles with hyperlinks to all the right slides, and just like that, you have a fully functional software simulation with pop-up tooltips. Let me just get rid of these first two slides, and now that I'm done, I'll just go over to the iSpring Converter Pro tab and click Publish. Change the title and destination if you like, then pick a format, and go ahead and publish. After just a few seconds, the preview window will open up, and then you can check out how it looks on different devices and share it right away with iSpring Cloud or email, or upload it right to your website via FTP. Thanks for watching. Now you're ready to create an interactive software simulation right in PowerPoint. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.